Germany announces a three-stage plan to gradually ease its COVID restrictions. That says officials there believe an Omicron-fueled wave has passed its peak. Under the plan, restrictions on private indoor meetings for those vaccinated or for those who have recovered from the virus will be lifted in the coming days. Checks at non-essential stores will also end, though masks will still be required. More easing is expected in the spring, which starts next month. On Wednesday, Germany reported a 6% week-on-week decline in daily COVID cases. The World Health Organization, meanwhile, warns countries from putting too much stock in declining COVID cases. The global body says a drop in testing rates is likely the reason for falling case reports. They also note that deaths due to the virus are rising. In the last week alone, the WHO reported 75,000 fatalities worldwide. That's the sixth week in a row that that number has increased.
I'm a bit nervous right now that we're sort of just lifting everything, and we're and if we get hit with another variant, we've already sort of abandoned all measures, it's going to be really hard to put anything back in place. Now, it could be that the deaths we're seeing now are a lag from a few weeks ago, and that's one explanation. The other explanation is that testing rates have dropped off remarkably in many countries. So countries who are claiming now to say our transmission has dropped and we've got 2 to 3-fold less cases this week than we had 6 weeks ago, go and look at the testing rates and you see that the testing rates are much lower.
As COVID vaccine supplies begin to stabilize, poor nations have another thing to worry about. As this report tells us, the short shelf life of AstraZeneca's COVID-19 vaccine is limiting the rollout of the donated shots to the world's poorest.
The relatively short shelf life of AstraZeneca's COVID-19 vaccine has complicated the rollout to the world's poorest nations. That's according to officials and internal World Health Organization documents viewed by Reuters. It is the latest headache to plague the COVAX vaccine-sharing project, co-led by the WHO and aimed at getting shots to the world's neediest people. According to COVAX data and officials, the problem with a short shelf life largely concerns AstraZeneca, COVAX's second biggest supplier after Pfizer. Many vaccines are arriving with only a few months, sometimes weeks, before their use-by date. Some countries have had to destroy expired doses, including Nigeria, which dumped up to 1 million AstraZeneca vaccines in November. 2.5 months of shelf life is the minimum duration African countries reckon they need to administer the shots. But AstraZeneca said since the start of the global rollout, more than 250 million of its shots left factories with less than 2.5 months before expiry. Gavi, the non-profit that co-runs COVAX alongside the WHO, said about 30 million AstraZeneca shots were rejected or deferred last year by poor nations. That amounts to a quarter of AstraZeneca-donated shots via COVAX. Many were later reassigned to other countries, Gavi added, noting that more than 95% of them were AstraZeneca. It did not say where to. Other than short shelf life, COVAX's complex system to assign doses to countries, donor requests to deliver them to selected nations, and quality checks often eat into the vaccine's short life. Millions of Moderna and Pfizer vaccines could also go wasted, some African countries warned in the WHO document. The problem has been often linked to low vaccine uptake and insufficient cold chain equipment to distribute these shots in remote regions. Gavi said it has encouraged AstraZeneca to apply to the WHO for an extension of the expiration date. But talks have not led yet to a formal application.
Police in Canada's capital have started threatening protesters with arrest if they do not leave the now 3-week-long blockade. We have more from this report.
Leave or face arrest. That's the message on leaflets handed out by police in Ottawa on Wednesday to truckers and protesters blockading the city's downtown. And it looks like the first step in a promised crackdown to end a noisy but largely peaceful protest in the Canadian capital over the government's COVID-19 restrictions, now in its third week. At least one large rig did leave the blockade, but others remained unmoved. One demonstrator simply ripped it up. And a sign posted on a toilet in the protest area read, "Attention police, place all tickets here." Police say some 33 people have already been arrested. Protester Andrew Bro said, if it happens to him, so be it.
"I'm not afraid. If that's what their captains and the police chief wants to bring to this peaceful protest is violence, then that is on their own. We're here peacefully and we'll remain peacefully. Even if they attempt to arrest us, we will be arrested peacefully."
Ottawa residents who say they've endured some incessant honking, blocked streets, verbal harassment, and litter have expressed frustration with police who, until now, have mostly watched the protest rather than intervening.
"This is not a peaceful protest."
As pressure built, Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau this week took a rare measure, invoking Canada's Emergencies Act, which, pending parliamentary approval, would empower his government to cut off protesters' funding and reinforce provincial and local law enforcement with federal officers. The federal public safety minister on Wednesday blamed extremist groups for helping organize protests in Ottawa and at U.S. border crossings. Police in the province of Alberta this week arrested 13 people linked to a border blockade there and seized guns. Four members of the group have been charged with conspiracy to commit murder.